Hello and welcome to Pwn2Own Tokyo 2018. We have over $500,000 available in cash and prizes in this year's contest. Today, we've got three different groups of contestants going after 11 targets across three categories. Let's get started. Our day began with Fluoracetate, the team of Amet Kama and Richard Zhu, successfully exploiting the Xiaomi Mi6 handset via NFC. Using the Touch to Connect feature, they forced the phone to open the web browser and navigate to their specially crafted web page. During the demonstration, we didn't even realize that action was occurring until it was too late. In other words, a user would have no chance to prevent this action from happening in the real world. The web page used an out-of-bounds write in WebAssembly to get code execution on the phone. This started off the contest great, with $30,000 awarded and 6 Master of Pwn points. Next up, the team from MWR Labs, which consists of Georgi Gishev, Fabi Bertecki, and Rob Miller, also targeted the Xiaomi Mi6. When the phone connected to their Wi-Fi server, they forced the default web browser to navigate to a portal page, much like joining the Wi-Fi at a coffee shop. Then, they chained additional bugs together to silently install an application via JavaScript, bypass the application whitelist, and automatically start their application. In all, they used 5 different bugs chained together for this demonstration, which earned the team $30,000 and 6 Master of Pwn points. The Fluoracetate duo returned, this time targeting the Samsung Galaxy S9. They made quick work of it by using a heap overflow and the baseband component to get code execution. Baseband attacks are especially concerning since someone can choose not to join a Wi-Fi network, but they have no such control when connecting to baseband. The work they showed earned them another $50,000 and 15 more Master of Pwn points. Next up, Matt and Richard return to the short distance category. This time, they were targeting the iPhone X over Wi-Fi. They used a pair of bugs, a JIT vulnerability in the web browser, followed by an out-of-bands write for the sandbox escape and escalation. This successful demonstration earned them $60,000 and 10 additional Master of Pwn points. This ends their first day of competition with $140,000 total and a commanding lead of Master of Pwn for 31 points. Following that attempt, the team from MWR Labs combined 3 different bugs to successfully exploit the Samsung Galaxy S9 over Wi-Fi. They forced the phone to a captive portal without user interaction, then used an unsafe redirect and an unsafe application load to install their custom application. Although their first attempt failed, they nailed it on their second try to earn $30,000 and 6 more points towards Master of Pwn. In our last entry of the day, Michael Contreras made sure his first Pwn2Own attempt was memorable. He wasted no time in exploiting a type confusion bug in JavaScript on the Xiaomi Mi6 browser. In doing so, he earned himself $25,000 and 6 Master of Pwn points. It was a fantastic demonstration, and we look forward to seeing his work at future events. That wraps up day one. So far, we had 6 attempts and 6 perfect successes. We awarded $225,000 in total, and purchased 13 bugs. Stay tuned for us tomorrow, where we'll be back with even more bugs, including more iPhone exploits and more Samsung exploits. Thanks, we'll see you then.